Kaya with this Como at the Grove. Getting so big. Kaya. Oh, he can press, let him press the button. Oh my god, look at you running. Yay, good job. High five. Yeah. Well, I'm currently at my parents' place in Los Angeles. I decided to drive down to Grand Prix San Diego and drop off Kyle, who somehow is currently in his skivvies as it is a bit hot in the house, so my parents just took off his clothes. But anyways, I am headed down to San Diego. I'm gonna leave Saturday morning. And basically, you know, I was gone for a week, so I feel kind of bad for Lisa because she had to, you know, watch Kyle for a week while I was testing for the Pro Tour. So I decided to give her a weekend off. So I drove down with Kyle, leaving Kyle at my parents' place, driving down to San Diego Saturday morning, coming back Sunday afternoon, then driving back up to San Jose. So it's a lot of driving, but you know, it's, you know, things that you have to do, you know, as being part of grown up. So anyways, you know, after a lot of thinking and figuring out what I want to play for the Grand Prix, you know, the first thing that came to my mind was, all right, well, what, you know, what are the two top decks? Thopters and Mono Red. So I need to find a deck that beats both of those decks. Well, What other decks did well at the tournament? Well, Brian Kibler went 9-1 with green-white, like a mid-range green-white deck. And after looking at it, the deck actually looks fairly solid. And, you know, because he went 9-1, because he wrote an article about it, you know, he's going to talk about the deck a lot. I feel like green-white is going to be an incredibly popular deck at the Grand Prix. Because it, on paper, it does have a good matchup against both mono-red and Blue Red Thopters. You know, you're playing Dromoka's Command, you're playing aggressive creatures, you know, and a lot of that makes it so that, you know, the red decks are going to have trouble keeping up because the green white creatures are just going to be better a lot of the time. Then, you know, I actually tweaked the green white deck to put 3 Wingmate Rocks in the main deck, and a friend of mine is probably going to end up playing that list, and Wingmate Rock has also been fantastic against Thopters and Mono Red. And here's my thinking though. First of all, there's going to be a ton of people playing the green white deck. How do I next level that? Well, just play Abzan. I think Abzan is one of those decks where game one, you might not be the best against a lot of the other card decks in the format, but it is, you know, has access to one of the best sideboard cards. And I think, you know, another thing that makes me want to play the deck is Abzan. This the Abzan control, at least, has a really good matchup against the green-white deck. So I'm Kibblering all the people who are playing Kibler's deck, basically. My plan is to play Abzan Control, and I have a sideboard basically just dedicated to making sure that I have a good matchup against Mono Red, Artifacts, and Green White. Now, Mono Red is not going to be the best matchup, but you know, I have 11 cards that I bring in, all of which are pretty solid, so hopefully that's going to be enough. And against Thopters, I'm, you know, playing 2 Dromoka's Commands and a couple of Unraveled the Aethers as well. So just kind of a rundown between for my thought process in terms of what I want to play. You know, I think it's kind of like taking that extra step. I think a lot of people are also going to make that conclusion. Maybe they go one step further than me and play Blue-Black Control, but I think that's pretty bad because Blue-Black has a really, really tough matchup against both Red and the Artifact deck. So you know, at least the Abzan deck, you know, after sideboard, you can make those matchups competitive, whereas I just don't think it's that easy to do when you're playing blue-black control. So, you know, I actually made this decision to change my deck Friday afternoon. I was going to play Abzan Megamorph, but I think going long is a little bit better against kind of the green-white deck, and I expect that to be actually one of the most popular decks in the format. So, I'm going to lay out the deck real quick, and then you guys will kind of see what I'm playing. Honestly, I'm basically just playing Matt Sperling and Pat Chapin's deck from the Pro Tour. So here is the deck we have. You know, I basically copied their Sperling and Chapin's mana base. It's exactly the same. I don't want to mess with something that they tested lots for a long time for. And basically the only card, as you can see, I have a couple of proxies here. Hopefully David Ochoa can get me settled for the GP. I sent him a list. I'm only missing a few cards. It's amazing how similar the cards are for Abzan Megamorph and Abzan Control. So we have basically the only change I made to the main deck is the fact that I think Ugin is a card more suited to play in the sideboard than in the main deck. The reason being, I think, you know, Mono Red and Thought Pierce are going to be pretty popular, and it's pretty bad against those matchups. And I'm just playing a Dromoka's Command instead, so cutting an 8-drop for a 2-drop, but I think having one Dromoka's Command in this deck is completely reasonable. So this is the deck here. And once again, the reason why I chose to play this over Abzan Megamorph is the fact that you have access to, you know, you have a better late game. You know, you have additional Planeswalkers in the Nissa, you have an extra Elspeth, and then in the sideboard you have access to the Ugin. But, you know, I wouldn't fault anybody for wanting to play the Abzan Megamorph deck. I think that deck matches up a little bit better against Mono Red because it has Deathmist Raptors. And looking at the sideboard here, we have two Drowns, two Ultimate Prices, a Dromoka's Command, three Fleece Mains, two Nyx Fleece Rams against the aggro decks. I asked Luis, what's better, the Ram or the Ram or the Irishan Cleric? And he said he liked the Ram more, so I'm playing two of those. Then we have two Unraveled Aethers for the Artifact deck. Then we move the Ugin to the sideboard and just playing one Read the Bones. I have less, you know, anti-control stuff. If you notice, I don't have the second Read the Bones and I don't have the Duress because I think I don't expect a lot of full control decks. So I'm choosing to go a little bit lighter on the... Kyle's getting scolded. I'm choosing to go a little bit lighter on the... I'm trying to go a little bit lighter on the Abzan... the anti-control stuff. And, you know, make sure I can just beat those top three decks. Because I do think that those are going to be the top three decks of the tournament. Green-white, blue-red Thopters, and mono-red. You heard it here. So I'm currently outside waiting for my friend in Beverly Hills. Man, the weather here is awesome. It's a little bit cloudy, but it's 70 degrees, and I forget what it's like to experience the Southern California weather, and we're gonna go down to San Diego where it's probably even nicer. So really looking forward to going to the tournament, playing. You know, I have 4 hours to get there because I did do the sleep-in special, and you know, I think the deck choice that I made is going to be solid for this tournament. It's nothing too special. It's just Abzan control, but you know, given what I'm expecting, it should do pretty well. Really important thing is if I play against a mono red decks, I have to win the die roll because it's pretty much unwinnable if you're on the draw, unless you draw like three Siege Rhinos. But yeah, on our way there, gonna meet up with a good friend, John Stocks, and yeah, see if we can win some rounds.
Recorded.
I am being recorded?
Right now.
Okay, well, good, because I'm driving.
That's exactly what you
on our way to San Diego. Well, how far are we, like 60 miles still?
Yeah, we're about 40 minutes out.
Okay. View's nice. This is a nice drive. I don't like the fact that I'm slowing down, but look, I mean, on the right side looks a beach. California love.
Got some nice beach views right here.
Yeah, look at that.
I would put the window down, but I'd be the person to drop a phone out the window.
Yeah, I know.
So
I cannot trust you with
So I'm not going to window down.
So here we are at the beautiful San Diego Convention Center. We're stuck in a little bit of traffic, but it's time. Yeah, it's pretty nice. Nice and clean. The weather's perfect. Oh, let's go. Alrighty, the side of Grand Prix San Diego. This is actually smaller than I expected, but it looks pretty packed. I mean, all the tables are nice and full. Where's the Channel Fireball booth? I gotta pick up some cards, but looks like, is this round one? No, it's gotta be round two. Round two, starting. Gotta find my friends. Web said he's at table 773. Yeah. Take a look at it. A little dragon, a little devotion, a little bit of everything. Alrighty. There's a Channel Fireball booth. Why is it all the way in the corner? Come on, they're running this event. Okay. Is that Wilson? Is he gonna be in this video? No, I'm probably gonna edit him out.
Photobomb.
Photobomb. So it's between round two and three. Now that I have three buys, boom, fish tacos. This is the place we frequent all the time when we went to the PTQs that were in San Diego, and they look pretty amazing.
As good as
thoughts?
Ever. I mean, still as good as ever.
And of course, the fries. Oh,
imagine being in San Diego, where the seafood is just right off the coast, and then you're getting the freshest possible fish taco that is delicious.
Is that actually true?
That's true.
All right.
Just tell this from right there.
Fact.
Fact.
Literally, from the ocean.
Right there.
Down that way. All right. Here we are at the coverage area. We have LSV. I'm too short for the marshal. We have TV doing a second Grand Prix. You like doing the coverage?
I do, yeah.
You prefer coverage than playing?
I like a mix. I generally, if I have to choose between only one or only one, that we don't play.
You would play?
Yeah.
Okay.
I like doing the mix.
Yeah, I mean, I enjoy doing it too. It's a lot of fun. So we're about to finish up on round three. Then doing the feature matches over here. And then next round, I get to actually play. But, you know, talking to a lot of the pros who, you know, it seems like Green White is actually very popular amongst the people in the know. So hopefully I made a good enough deck choice. And hopefully my matchup against Red isn't bad enough where I just get destroyed by all the Red decks. But I think that's the benefit of having three buys. Maybe some of the Red players will get weeded out by the time you get the fourth round. Kids, they just grow up so fast, you know. Look at this. My boy here. Oh my goodness. Hey. That's my son. Yeah, okay. It's about, you know, I'm gonna say 3 minutes prior to round four starting, and Raptor very, very prepared, as you can see. Sleeving up his deck. What is it? I'm doing my vlog, yes.
Vlog.
All right. It's a vlog.
As usual, I'm looking down on from Paul on high.
You're what?
I'm looking down on high.
Yeah, oh, okay. Yeah. Enjoy it. Oh my god. Earlier, I asked Luis if...
Pairings are online at gpsandiego.com.
What is spilling? Oh my god. I asked Luis earlier if he wanted food, and he's just like, actually, coverage is getting me food. And so, Luis, what is this? You know, you can use that as a holder. Anyways, and then he goes, yeah, so I have two things coming to me, but what are you getting? Is it actually leaking liquid, or is it just...
No. That'd be disgusting.
That would be not this. I mean,
that's not my fault. It's Raptor's fault.
Why is it Raptor's fault? He got you the burrito. Well, yeah, but that's just him being very generous. Oh my goodness. So got killed by Mono Red on turn four, games one and three. Pulled a five, game three. I actually had a pretty good hand. I went turn two ultimate price, turn three Corsair crew fix on the draw, game three, and he killed me on turn four. So. That is the power of the Utarka Red deck. You know, still like my deck. I'm level 5. I mean, you know, still got a long way to go. Luis is... being Luis.
I would say I'm ruining your schlog, but how do you ruin something called a schlog?
That's what you call it!
I didn't call it a schlog. Other people call it a schlog.
You've made it a thing.
I didn't come up with that.
So look, this is part of you know Luis's enjoyment just going to Grand Prix is just giving me a hard time obviously.
He goes Skyland.
Rapdog locked in on Jeskai.
My hand is
Grandstander. Every time I watch Raptor play, it looks like he's losing and then he does a bunch of stuff and ends up winning. For he is a master.
Appreciate it.
I've been liking you a lot as a co-host.
So somebody came up to me here, a viewer. And he asked me to sign a couple of cards, and they are in fact the Cheon Mageddon's. There you go.
Okay.
For you guys wondering, the Cheon Mageddon is me at Grand Prix Vancouver. It was a feature match, and I was cutting Mark Jacobson's deck. And as I went to go cut it, I basically just chucked all of the lands that he had on the board onto the floor. And ever since then, it's a pretty amazing gif. If you actually find it, I think you just type in, search for Cheon Mageddon and you'll find the gif. But I didn't get any warnings or anything. I just
you know, threw his deck onto the table. And I actually told Mark at the Pro Tour, which was also in Vancouver, like, if I play you again, man, I'm getting rid of your entire deck. I'm just throwing it across the room. But, yeah. Well, round five in the books, and lost again. I lost to Mono Red. Games 1 and 3, I got killed turn 4 again. This time, game 3, I was on the draw, and my hand was 4 lands, Nyx Police Ram, Corsair of Kruphix, Languish. So I go turn 2, Nyx Police Ram, turn 3, Corsair of Kruphix, and then he killed me on turn 4. He went Foundry Tree Denizen. Foundry Street Denizen, Swift Spear, Rabble Master on turn 3, turn 4, Stoke the Flame of Tarkus Command. So,
on demand events.
I mean, sometimes you have these, you know, very solid hands, you just can't pull off
next to the side of it.
One of those things where you just can't beat those matchups. So, you know, I mean, I still have a chance making it. I have to go 4-0, but that's a little disappointing to just not really be able to do anything about the losses. I mean, I could have played different decks, but losing 204 through disruption. I mean, you know, the Tarka red decks are very, very explosive, so it can't happen, but it still doesn't make it not sting. Well, that was really frustrating. I just lost the eighth round. I picked up my third loss, so I'm 5-3, and I dropped. Played against Abzan, won the first game, and game 3, I just didn't draw a third land until... Actually, I didn't draw a third land. He played Elspeth before I drew a third land. I kept, you know, Urborg, Windswept
Heath. As a reminder, players,
Thought
we are currently
ultimate price,
taking registration Nyssa, for tomorrow morning,
you know,
Super
on the play,
Sunday
and
Series Sealed
I thought it was
event.
Reasonable keep. I didn't have the third land, but I had the Nyssa
you
too
know
with the Thoughtseize.
You
so.
Play in tomorrow's Super Sunday Series event.
Really disappointing.
We would like you to register
preparation,
to
and I thought
you may
the deck I chose was pretty solid for the tournament, but... You know, today was just not my day. I just.
But once again, we are currently taking registration.
Just combination of a lot of things. Didn't draw particularly well, and got run over by some red decks. So I got to get myself together. We have GP Detroit next week. You know, I'll be coming back tomorrow, recording some friends play, and you know maybe a couple of buddies of mine can win the GP. But that is the end of the tournament for me. A quick end. It's been a while since I. Missed out on day two. It was actually the last time I missed out on day two of a GP was last year in San Antonio, standard. Doesn't feel good. So I was at the bar hanging out with a couple of good friends of mine. We're now heading over to Fogo to meet up with Frodog and Luis and Marshall Sutcliffe. But good times. I mean, we're all losers here.
Hey,
wait a second.
Well,
To
be fair, this loser was out a round before us.
I won my
So he went to the bar,
events,
but,
right?
But here I am with
pre-funked.
With my son, stream superstar Kenji Igashira, aka Numa Tanami. About to go to Fogo. He already ate. Are you eating again?
Well, I can't just eat once.
I mean, to be fair, yeah. I mean, you are a Humfling, so that makes sense.
I have a question for you, sir. What is a Numa?
It's like tasty nummy.
Oh, nummy. Yeah. Nummy.
See, the nummy doesn't make sense. Numot is the dragon.
Yeah.
What is a nummy?
Numot's so tasty.
It's like a...
It's a tasty Numot.
Yeah.
It's a tasty.
It's like tasty. It's like tasty delicious. Dragon. You know.
Are you talking about umami or...
No.
Numot
like,
the umami.
It's like a describer word
Numot
for food.
Numot the umami nummy.
Really? I never heard of nummy before.
Nums.
Yeah, when you're feeding a baby. Nummy. It's so nummy.
Nummy,
I've heard that. I'm with you on
that. I'm just going to say I've never nummied Kyle. But perhaps, you know, Kenji's been nummied a few times. But
I will say
on a way to hang out with some buddies.
The first couple times that I saw them.
Gold Pro. Did you introduce yourself, Paul Cheon? You're Paul Cheon.
I'm Gold Pro Paul Cheon.
Oh, really?
I hug everybody.
Oh my God, wow. Like a foot taller, that's all, but no big deal. All right.
He grew and he became white.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Is that lovely? I probably should have.
Yeah. Taller,
better. Wow, just everything. Jesus Christ.
He's a strictly better Cheon.
Just continue to move down the rankings.
Power rankings.
Yeah.
I'm on the power rankings.
Yeah. We need to do some coverage together, and then he'll definitely. Like anytime I'm in contact with somebody, they become a Cheon. So that's just what happens. Athena 8-1. Congratulations. Wow, that was a very pretty face. You know.
Only the best for the Chalog.
Oh, only the best for the Chalog. That is true.
I've heard about it.
I tried so hard to not make it a thing. I tried so hard.
You have the patent.
You can't stop it.
I try. I'm like, Luis, this is not clever. It's not very funny, and it doesn't sound good. And Luis is like,
schlog.
Yeah. It doesn't. And now everybody in the
comments.
Yeah, and everybody in the comments is now like, schlog, schlog, schlog. I'm just like, no, of course not, because he's made a bunch of other unfunny things funny by repeating it multiple times.
He just says it over and over.
It's easy when it's funny. I've been to schlog.com.
Schlog.com, unfortunately, is already registered as Chapel Hill Login Services.
That was part of our Pro Tour test.
You have to be able to buy it from.
Is it like paul.schlogspot.com?
Yeah.
Schlogspot.com.
It is pretty great that we have paulcheon.com and luiscottvargas.com. Like,
don't worry, I know who actually owns luiscottvargas.
Oh god, somebody found you actually know?
Luiscottvargas.com.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yes.
I hope he doesn't change it though. I gotta talk to him now.
I'm in arrangements
with him. Oh no, I gotta talk to him now. So wait, I would pay any amount of money now.
You do not own luiscottvargas.com.
No.
Is
not currently.
Yeah.
No. No, I don't. Somebody made it to troll Luis behalf.
One of the guys we know does.
Why did he message you? Oh, that's such a fun. I was. It was
I
a
do,
secret.
I do own paulcheon.com.
He does. God, this is till. This is a massive, massive till.
He was so proud of himself when he bought it.
I was.
Yeah, I'm sure he did a lot of giggling. I'm sure he did a lot of giggling and on his tippy toes. Yeah. He's just doing it right now.
Kind of like when I registered our team's meeting number 7 Bells Enterprises.
Yeah, nobody understand what that was.
Yeah. Right.
People thought it was the wrong room.
Yeah, that's even greater.
Yeah.
You did it this way.
Marshall, we have somebody that's on your level now.
No, I told them, ding, 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 ding. But yeah, everybody was like, no, sorry, this is the wrong room, 7 Bells Enterprises. And then they told me about it, and I'm just like, no, this is me, and Luis is being very stupid. Shahar, how'd you finish? 9-0. 9-0? Jeez. Up top. Wow, this guy.
High five. The kid.
What'd you say?
Shahar has more wins than all the Cheons put together.
No, we have nine total.
We have 9 total. Classic Shahar, 9-0 at the GP, also the only one to order dessert.
Twice.
We're all waiting for him. Twice. No, three times. This is the third dessert, right?
I got you guys free dessert. So
yeah. To be fair, yeah. The strawberry cheesecake was on him.
Back? I was like, why did you
he also
fly back
got about
to fly back?
Like, 12 okay. pieces of
he's like, when are you flying back? I'm like, well, I'm flying back.
He's, you know. I think it's meant to be shared.
I think I would actually like one more spoon if possible.
Enough to share it and know after.
Wait, one left. We're currently credit card gaming. I was safe right away. Number 3.
I hear you.
They
just canceled.
Oh, it's me. Okay. Ooh. Yeah. But you have Geneva's card still in there.
No, I'm gonna
count
that as
mine. Oh, okay.
1 through 4, Paul.
3 again. Shahar also said that his credit card got rejected earlier today, and he still put his credit card in the credit card game.
Shahar, 1 through 3.
Oh, he had to check.
I mean, but he knew he wasn't going to lose, so to be fair.
My God.
Wow. Up top, the Cheons are safe. Cheons are safe.
One of the resources is
yeah. One of the resources will be very limited.
Which one is more about to be more limited?
But this, you guys did next level, right?
Yeah.
I think they did. Okay. They're next leveling. For those of you guys wondering, the next level game is anybody who buys out, the second place person gets all the cash. All right, the loser pays for everything else.
Alright, Cardini Chan.
2.
It's on you, Kenji.
Cardini Chan.
Oh. We'll go with this one.
This one pays?
Pays nope. Safe?
It pays or it's safe?
Safe.
Oh, safe!
This one's safe.
That one's safe. Wow, I thought it was pays. I thought it was pays. Oh my goodness. How could you do this?
The check is in there.
Who are you rooting for?
Sorry, Mark.
Oh, now we know. Thanks, Marshall. The dinner was great. Yeah, I really do appreciate it. So we just finished having dinner here. We had the very generous Marshall Sutcliffe pay for dinner. Thank you. It tastes extra good. It was so good.
I ate a little extra on the way out. Just to
Yeah. I almost consider ordering an extra dinner. Later, Kenji. So here we are at the Harrah's at RingCon, which I was promised was a 30-minute drive away, and it took us almost an hour. We were driving down the mountains for like half an hour, and now, you know, we're headed to our room, but yeah, Mr. John Stocks, the navigator. I think he said it was just 30 minutes, just so like, we're like, yeah, we'll come, 30 minutes. We're driving 30 minutes through orange fields. Now we're in.
I was gonna say, did you move when I was gone in Europe?
No. That'd be pretty. This is day two. Paul Rietzel battling. I believe he's in top 8 contention, otherwise you likely wouldn't be here. But yeah.
He has two losses.
Two losses? Okay, so yeah, two losses. So if he wins this, he can probably draw into top 8. Oh man, I just showed up really late today. Stayed up pretty late last night did not make day 2. And then I got tricked by my friend John Stock. He basically told me that it was a 30-minute drive away, and only to put it in my GPS and find that it was an hour and 20 minutes away north, which is on the way to my house. So basically I drove an hour up to be fair, the hotel was very nice, but I drove an hour north to go to a hotel, then an hour back south to come back to the venue just to record more of the vlog,
vlogging.
Because yeah, Michael was like, why are you going back? Well, you're not gonna do some recording. I gotta record some of the action, you know? Some of the Magic's finest players here, you know, Owen Turnbull, Jacob Wilson, Huey Jensen, and Matt Ness, I guess.
Help you out.
How are you fellas doing today?
Well, I just lost, but I'm just feeling good.
Playing for top...
I'm X3 now.
You were X2?
I lost to Jerry.
Oh, jeez. So you can still like top 16 or whatever, but get 3 pro points? Yeah, is it next round the last round?
Next round's last.
All right, good luck. What are you doing?
Just jogging them. Seeing that, it's like, did mulling to 5 that last game feel good, Bowen?
Oh my god. Oh, just a Robbins?
All right, Super Sunday series player.
I think if he hadn't flipped Nissa, if he'd flipped a creature instead.
Who'd you play?
Jerry
Thompson. Okay, yeah. Devotion's good.
Minutes.
Hey, you know what's funny? In his article, he said, I'm not going to play Devotion. I'm probably going to play something else.
Yeah.
And then he played Devotion. Shahar, how are you doing today? I just showed up.
Not well. I am 2-3.
2-3 on a day?
Yeah.
That was my record yesterday, so you know. But sorry. One more round for 3 pro points.
Did you see the coverage players to watch today?
No, see, I don't watch any of the coverage, but I've been told now on Twitter multiple times that Luis posted a players to watch. He actually said he was going to do this yesterday.
Yeah, it was like 12 people with good records and then just Paul Cheon 3-3 dropped.
Yeah, like what the hell? I 2-3 dropped, but whatever. Well, and they had it up multiple times.
How nice.
Wait, yeah, I know.
Why did you three buys?
No, I went 5-3 drop.
Oh,
but like
okay.
I physically won 2 matches.
Oh, sure. So and
he gave me a win.
Well, that
can't be too mad. That's
pretty nice. Yeah, players to watch. I'm sure the chat loved it.
Yeah.
So ridiculous. What is the name of this game? What is the name of this game?
Heads up.
Heads up?
Creatures with reach can block.
So something goes on Shahar's phone, or is on the phone, and we say words, but that's not the actual word. And he has to try to guess what it is. So we have to use association.
If you cast
association. Caw, caw, caw. Can you say caw, caw?
Blue, white, red.
Is it dragons or the
flag?
Blue, white, red.
Jeskai.
Yeah. Wow, that's good. Molten Rain.
Land Destruction.
Stone Rain.
Village.
Counterbird.
You can go up.
Yeah.
Stone Rain.
Crispacoola.
Crispacoola. Crispacoola. Oh, man. He's so mad. Crispacoola. What?
I'm very bad.
That was in real. What was your first guess on Crispacoola? Did you just not have a guess?
Well, he said Hall of Famer, and I said pro.
Oh. Okay, here we go.
But I was like.
Green, black.
Black, green, red.
British Hall of Famer.
He loves playing elves.
He's British.
He is kind of British.
He's British.
His nickname is the Arena Man.
He loves wearing Hawaiian shirts.
Oh, Alan Comer.
Yes!
Oliver is not British.
Oh god, pass.
Just jumped in.
Please report to the GP.
People battling. They're all better at Magic than me because I'm not playing and they are. I'm very sad. Yes, I don't know who called my name. Yeah, I just hear things, so you know.
Yeah,
yeah, it's like.
Did this match finish?
No.
Oh, okay. Ooh, this is a good one. I don't know who I should be rooting for. Webb. I should be rooting for Webb. I'm rooting for Webb. He lost his voice partying last night, is what I heard. Ooh, it's the mirror. I don't know if the bow is good in the mirror. What do you think? Game three.
I think about the bow.
Yeah, yeah.
I think this is game two.
Who won first?
Tom.
Oh, okay. It is a good magic card, very powerful. I think this is a thing that people do. It's called the Ross Hunnids. So there you go. Just for all the people who follow Mr. Ross Merriam. I had to do it. Two of Magic's youngest, brightest stars. And one of Magic's oldest players. Oh God.
You can get me in a picture if you like.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ben Rubin showing up. It's camera, it's video. Ben.
Yeah.
BR showing up to the GP Sunday, 4 p.m. His first appearance. No big deal.
Strolls in.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, do people still money draft these days? Or I would draft. Well, I only have a couple hours. Shahar and Jacob Wilson playing for 3 pro points, right? Is that what they're doing? They're playing for 3 pro points?
Yeah.
So this is a big game, actually. Playing the mirror.
Like 75 card mirror.
70 card, yeah. Shahar doesn't even know what's in a sideboard, to be fair, though. Yeah. But he'll probably get lucky. It also looks like he is getting destroyed. So I'm talking to a couple friends here, trying to figure out what deck to play for the Standard Super League. I need to submit it by tomorrow. And Matt Nassier and Kevin Chu suggested the Hardened Scales deck. I'm not exactly sure how that deck works.
Abzan Falconer.
Abzan, is that really in the deck? No.
It's
a
Yuka Heroes deck.
What, are you serious? Yeah. Abzan Falconer was in the deck?
Pro Tour with Abzan Falconer.
That's probably just because he's a master and he's probably 5-1 limited.
Probably.
You know, couldn't you play the Mill deck? Well, actually, the Mill deck's in the top 8, but.
Yeah. Serpent of the Scale, Hardened Scales, Avatar the Resolute.
You get the play
Hardened Scales? Yeah. Oh, and then there's Luis. Well, they're trying to suggest what deck I should be playing at the thing, the Standard Super League. So they told me to play the Hardened Scales deck.
That didn't seem good, but you could play it.
I was thinking about Esper Dragons. I think Esper Foul Tongue is really good against the new mono red version. There's
no
tokens.
Tell you about the players to watch.
Did anybody tell me about it? Literally every single person I met when I showed up today, which was an hour ago, went up to me and was like, "Paul, did you see the players to watch?"
What? No, I had nothing to do with it until it just showed up on the screen and I was like, "Whoa."
No, he definitely, it was all him. He talked to Avi and then got Avi to put in the players to watch.
X3 or better on the graphic.
Yeah, is that really what you did? No, I was the only one eliminated from the tournament that was under the players to watch. What are you watching for?
X3 was 7-3 for most people. It might have been 3-3 for you.
Also, you guys gave me an additional win.
Oh, really?
It said I was 3-3 drop. 2-3? I went 2-3 drop.
Wow.
Yeah. I can't believe. And I heard you guys put it up multiple times in the coverage.
We only mentioned it like 3 or 4 times.
No. I heard like after the 3rd or 4th time it was on the slide, they're like, all right, maybe we should finally put it down.
But then we just didn't use the slide again.
Well, that way, what's the point of the slide?
Yeah, that's true.
Unreal. Oh my God. Top 8 matches here.
Player Christian Matthews. Please report to the side of the stage.
Well, anybody can top 8 these days.
Dude, don't let anybody sign up for a GP. They let me in.
Can I get a Hall of Famer elect to like team with me for the next 2 like GPs?
No, I already cornered the market on that one, sorry. Yeah.
Can I get 2 Hall of Famers then? Are there like 2?
Yeah, I mean you can try. I corner the mart. I corner the market on teaming with Hall of Famers. That's just what I do. The best way is to ride the coattails of people better than you, to carry you to victory. This is a team Channel Fireball and ish, whatnot. The Berkeley guys.
The
Berkeley guys testing for Grand Prix Detroit, laying out their pools. Looks like we have a green white deck here, a blue black deck with three spells. To be fair, their creatures are spells. They have two Void Mages and a Scab and a Winnower. And
basically, just all Shriek Moths.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so, I mean, the deck's gotta be decent.
We'll do our best
maybe a Mono Red deck.
We'll find out.
Is Sphinx Tutelage good in Limited?
Sphinx of Tutelage? Yeah, yeah. In like a nice controlling deck. I don't know. Somehow, this deck might just attack.
It's gonna be a board card.
Yeah. It's not
could be good.
Format. You go off.
Yeah. You can build some sweet decks.
That's for sure.
You see any Sphinx of Tutelage draft deck?
The triple majoring bully deck.
Ben Stark drafted a mono blue Tutelage deck.
Yeah, I saw that before.
I had 3 in team draft. It was pretty sweet.
You had like 2 waves.
I feel like you want a lot of combat tricks if you want to be playing like all the prowess guys here.
Yeah, it's possible that that pairs better with this kind of green card.
This is my final opponent for this tournament in Grand Prix San Diego. Me and Micah are going to be battling
Battle Box.
Some of the Battle Box. Inspired by the man way over there, Mr. Ben Stark.
Yeah.
He loves the Battle Box. He thinks it's one of the purest forms of magic. So let's battle. Are you ready?
I am not ready because I'm going to lose.
In a few seconds, we're going to show the board state after. And we'll see. We'll see. Because Ben did say the better player wins 90% of the time.
Yeah. If you would have lost.
No. And the aftermath. I got Micah pretty low. He chose to putrefy my guy. And Psionic Blast! Your face!
You did it!
Yay! Alrighty. What are we gonna do now?
Go home.
You wanna run it back?
Run it back? Go home? I don't know.
Are you tired of losing though? Or?
Yeah, I'm a little tired of losing.
Alright.
It's no fun.
Got PV and Luis doing Paul Rietzel's match here, playing Abzan Control. So it wasn't a terrible choice. It's just, you know, if it's piloted by a better player, you can get better results. It is Rietzel's birthday, so, you know, running well.
Old man Rietzel.
Old man Rietzel, yes. We'll call him Old Paul.
Paul, you're...
To be fair, I'm not really young. So I have returned to Los Angeles and, you know, going to be driving back home to San Jose tonight, but it is Monday and I still needed to figure out exactly what deck I'm going to submit for the Standard Super League. I do need to submit a deck for... Come here. Kyle, you're going to see mommy today. Are you happy to see mommy? Mommy. That's outside. Do you want to go outside later? Okay, not right now. Just give me a second. So anyways, yeah, I've been trying to figure out what to play, and I just kind of wanted to play something that I find to be really fun, and come here. The deck that I want to play is Esper Dragons. I had a lot of fun playing it at the Pro Tour, and I want to draw a lot of cards. So, boom, right on the monitor here, Esper Dragons. It's a combination of Robin Dollar's List and... the deck that actually top 8 at the most recent Grand Prix, but pretty straightforward here. We got our 27 lands, 3 Thought Seizes, 2 Bioblades, 2 Ultimate Prices, 4 Scorns and Anticipate, 1 Ashiok, 4 Jutai, Silum Guard. There's 2 Languishes, and actually I was talking to Ben Stark over the weekend, and he said he didn't like Crux that much in the main, but really did like Languish. You know, the argument that Languish kills Ojutai, you know, obviously that is not a combo, but just being able to have a sweeper on turn 4 is super important. And you know, you just it also sequences well when you just play Languish into Ojutai. And if you're constantly hitting them with Ojutai, you're likely already very far ahead. And if you're not, and if they attack and kill your Ojutai, you can still cast a Languish afterwards. So he said he really liked Languish a lot. And then you know, the classic sideboard suite of Drowning Sorrows, Foul Tongues, Ultimate Price, and I'm playing a couple of Farika's Cures for the Mono Red matchup instead of Virulent Plague. So, that's the deck that I'm going to be battling with. Week 1, I'm going to be battling against Numat Nummy, Kenji Gashira, father-son battle, and should be good. You know, he's one of my, one of the tougher competitors amongst the three people that I had to play against, because he plays more Magic than probably all three of us combined. So, looking forward to battling against him,
and hopefully I made a decent choice for the tournament. But that was GP San Diego, and I was looking at the coverage on my drive back, like I just had it on my phone and listening to it, and wow, can you believe it? Blue Red Mill. Congratulations to Michael Majors for taking down Grand Prix San Diego with Blue Red Mill, a deck designed by Andrew Cuneo. You know, it's one of those decks, I look at it and I'm just like, how do you possibly be a mono red? Because I feel like mono red should be able to just completely crush the deck, but it is a deck that is well situated for day two of this Grand Prix, because you know, coming into the tournament, everybody wants to beat Blue Red Thopters and mono red, and the decks that tend to do that are more mid-range based green decks, which are kind of slower. How do you beat the mid-range based green decks that are slower? Blue Red Mill. I mean, he was able to kill on turn 5 in one of the matches in the finals against Abzan Constellation. So apparently it's a real deck, and you know, I fully expect a lot of people to either try out the deck or play a bunch of cheap aggressive creatures to be able to fight it, because you know, I'm actually excited to try the deck myself because it seems kind of sweet, but I don't know, it still boggles the mind. I still don't know how exactly this deck was able to go through a sea of Thoppers and mono red and win the tournament, but yeah, I guess the deck works, and you know, once again, Cuneo just brewing up another deck that actually happens to be good. You know, a lot of times they look a little wacky, and when I looked at this deck at the Pro Tour, I'm like, man, if only Cuneo played a real deck, he would have done better at the Pro Tour, but guess he did, you know, he actually did create a pretty powerful deck here, because I was able to win the Grand Prix. So once again, congratulations to Mike Majors, winner of Grand Prix San Diego.